Want to know how to use Jian Ying, the Chinese version of CapCut on PC? With this video, I'm going to translate the functions and show you where they are located in the app. If you want to see a tutorial on how to use a specific feature in this app, please comment down below. Now let's get started. First, you can go to this website and then click on this icon to download the app. Since I already downloaded it, I'm just going to open the app. This is what the front looks like when you open it. Click here to log in to your account. You only can log into it if you have a Chinese TikTok account. Local drive, my cloud drive, which you only have access if you can log into a Chinese TikTok account. Popular activities. Let's go back here. So here's your drive. You can view it as icon or list, whichever way you like. When you click on the three dot, backup to cloud drive, rename, duplicate drive, delete. Then you can click on the blue icon to confirm it. Let's click on the top right icon here for setting. Go to setting. Location of the drive, cache management, do not delete cache file, delete cache file automatically after however many days you select, cache size, proxy mode. Proxy is where it would lower the resolution and file size, so when you edit, it would be more smooth if you have like big file, but when you export it, it would use the original file. Turn off proxy mode as default when you open a new project. Turn on proxy mode as default when you open a new project. Proxy location, proxy size, stock files, download location, free layer, which allow you to arrange the overlay layer to the order that you like if it's on. Free layer turn off as default when open a new project. Free layer turn on as default when you open a new project. So you just make a selection and click on the blue icon to save it after you are done. Now click on this icon to start creating a new project. This one is media, local, cloud drive, stock videos. You will import the videos under the local. Click on here to import your files. You can view your clips in icon mode or click on here to change it to list, whichever way you like. You can click on here to import more. Then you can click on the plus icon to move the clip to the timeline. Or you can drag it to the timeline. You can also click on the clip and then trim off to how you like it before you move it to the timeline. You can also drag it to the overlay track like this. And for audio, you just do the same thing. You can use the plus icon and drag it. So that's for the media. Now let's click on the clip and go to the right side. The first tab is for image or videos, whatever clip you have. Basic, location and size, zoom in or out, so you can change the size. Location, which you can type in the number of X and Y, or you can move it to however you like. Rotate, you can rotate it here, or you can rotate it here. You can also adjust the size like this. You can use keyframe by clicking on this icon if you're gonna like change the size or location of it. So let's have it on here. Then go to the next spot. And then make it bigger. And you can see it generate a keyframe here. So when you see this icon, it means add a keyframe. Splice mode, here's where you can select splice. opacity, beauty enhancement, smooth skin, slim face. The next one, chroma key, color picker, intensity, shadow, remove background, mask, canvas, blur, color, background. Then let's go to the next one, animation, in, out, combo, adjust, basic, LUT, which you can import, skin color protection, you can have it on or off, adjust, temperature, hue, saturation, brightness, contrast, highlight, shadow, exposure, sharpen, grain, fade, vintage, HSL, hue, saturation, luminance, curve, color wheel, primary wheel, lift, gamma, gain, offset, log wheel, shadow, midtone, highlight, offset, saturation, brightness. You can click on here to save the preset so you can use it next time. Now let's move on to the next one, audio. Music audio, sound effects, extract audio from a file, Chinese TikTok favorite, download from a link. Now let's click on audio and go to the right side. So for the basic, volume, fade in duration, fade out duration, audio noise reduction, voice effect, speed, pitch. So for picture, we don't see speed, but if you click on a video file, then on the second one, you would see speed. So this is the normal speed and curve speed, which is pretty much the same as what you see in the app. Now let's go to the next one, text. Default text, so you can click on it to add in your text. Here is where you can type in your text. Font, size, style, bold, underline, italic, color, preset, spacing, character, line, alignment. This one is pretty much the same of what you see earlier. So this is to zoom in or zoom out. This is to change the location, rotate. You can also add keyframe to it if you want. Opacity, stroke, color, thickness, canvas, color, opacity, shadow, color, opacity, blur, distance, angle. You can also click on here if you want to save the text as preset to use it later. Which it will show up on here. This one is bubble, effects text, animation, in, out, loop, text to speech, since this is mainly for Chinese, so some of them might not work for English text, so you can experience with it. The next one for text is defect text, then text template, auto caption. This one is where it would match script. So if you type in your script and if you say those in your video, then it would try to match the script of what you say in your video. Recognize lyric. Since this is mainly for Chinese, I don't know how well it works with English song, but feel free to try that out. Next one is sticker. To use sticker, you can click on the plus icon or drag it to the timeline, however you want to use it. So when you click on the sticker, you can see the position size, which is similar to the other one. This is where you can zoom in, zoom out the size of it, location, rotation, and then you can add keyframe, animation, in, out, loop, effects. So for the effects, you can click on the plus icon, which would apply the effect to all the clip, or you can drag it to the specific clip that you want to use it. You can click on the edge part to trim it to use it at certain part. On the right side, you can see the different adjustment to it, but it depends on which effect you use, so it might have different adjustment. So you can just play around with it. Next one is transition. So you can click on plus icon or drag it in between the two clip. Then on the right side, you can adjust duration of it. Filters. For the filter, pretty much you just use it the same way as effect. Either click on the plus icon or drag it to the picture or video that you want to use it on. Next one is adjust. Custom adjustment. So this is when you click on the clip and then go to the third one if it's a picture, or fourth one if it's a video. So pretty much it's the last one when you click on the clip. And then you can make adjustment to it, which you can save a preset, which we did earlier. My preset LUT is where you can import LUT file. So these are the function on here. Now let me go over the one over here. This one is to prioritize the resolution first when play the video. This one is to prioritize the performance first when you play the video. RGB Pre format, there are different ratio, or you can click on here to select custom. You want to go to the third one, and then this one is the length and this is the width. Then you can click on here to save it. This one is to see your video in full screen. Now let's go over this one. So this is the mouse selection. If you click on it, click on this one, then you can turn it into a blade and you can just click on the part where you can cut your clip. Let's go back to the mouse selection. And then when you click on the clip, you can see some of this function is available. This one's undo, redo, split, delete, freeze, reverse, mirror, rotate, crop. Voiceover, snapping on or off, magnetic timeline on or off, nest on or off, skimming on or off. This one is to zoom in the timeline or zoom out the timeline. Mute clip audio cover. Now let's click on the clip, right click, copy, cut, delete, hide clip, Edit effect, replace clip, display as non-movement picture, grip, ungrip, link media, recognize caption or lyric, extract audio, mark area, mark in, mark out, mark clip,
cancel mark clip,
freeze, reverse, mirror, rotate, crop.
If you go to the empty area and right click, the first one is paste, mark in, mark out, mark clip, cancel mark clip. You can also adjust the screen size by go to the edge part and then move them to however you want to adjust it.
Then you can click on this icon to export. File name, export to, resolution, bit rate, lower, recommend, higher, custom, format, frame rate. Then you can click on here to export the file after you are done. You can click on here for shortcut reference. You can use the Premiere Pro style or the Final Cut Pro style, depends on which app you have used before.
Here's other translation that I have done for the shortcuts, which I have spent a lot of time to research so I can match the name on Final Cut Pros and Premiere. If you notice any translation is not accurate, feel free to comment down below.
But overall, I think it's pretty good. So that's an overview of the functions on this app and where they are located. If you found this video to be helpful, please consider like and subscribe. And comment down below what's your favorite feature on this app.
As always, please be nice to yourself and have a wonderful day. I will see you next time.